For 1,000 years, we Tongans have treasured independence on our chain of islands in the warm South Seas. Captain Cook, who visited these shores on his voyage of discovery, enjoyed the hospitality so much that he renamed our islands the Friendly Isles. Tribal wars and skirmishes with our neighbors came to an end over 100 years ago when the missionaries brought Christianity. And King George Tupou I united the people of Tonga Tapu with those of Hapai and Vavao into the Kingdom of Tonga. To preserve our independence, King George sought British protection, and we still have a British consul to advise us. In 1965, our people mourned the loss of our third monarch, the beloved Queen Salote, who had guided and mothered us for nearly 50 years. Now, in 1967, after 6 months' preparation, everyone's gathering for the coronation and tama whakaava for His Majesty King Taufa'ahau Tupou IV. For a month, ships have been carrying people, crowds of people, with mountains of luggage from the northern islands, canoes and launches bringing families from the nearby islands. Everybody wants to see and give their love to the new king at Nuku'alofa. There's time to visit relations and renew family ties, as well as sampling the experiences of town shops and traffic. Some haven't seen cars or buses before. A traditional dance group greets the royal children who've just arrived from school in New Zealand to reunite with their families for this royal occasion. As the day draws nearer, the airport at Fua'amotu takes an international look. Guards drawn from the Tonga Defence Force meet each aircraft, carrying representatives from well-wishing countries. The Honourable Fiame Mata'afa leads the visitors from Western Samoa. Prime Minister, the Right Honourable K.J. Holyoake, leads the New Zealand group. But the tapa goes out for the aircraft of Queen Elizabeth II's flight, carrying her special representatives for the coronation. Their Royal Highnesses, the Duke and Duchess of Kent. Bursting with guests and visitors from Australia, Fiji, America, Samoa, Japan and Britain, who mingle in town with the crowds from the villages of Tonga Tapu and the other island groups. People arrive early for the best positions on this coronation day to watch the arrival of the VIPs and the royal procession to the chapel. The leader of New Zealand's opposition party, Mr. Kirk, Rata George Thakombau, Rata Mara, Ratu Edward Thakombau from Fiji, Prime Minister Mata'afa from Samoa. Prime Minister Mr. Holyoake and Minister of Justice Mr. Hannan from New Zealand. Inside, the Royal Chaplain, the Reverend Harris, and the President General of the Wesleyan Church in Australia, the Reverend Gribble, wait to perform the coronation ceremony.
Ko mau kua ki ki a fiona ai tohini
From the palace veranda, their majesties acknowledged the 12,000 schoolchildren filing through the royal grounds, rejoicing for their new king. Now, pigs and chickens have been fattened for this royal feast, and each village has vied with its neighbour in presenting the most succulent dishes for the hundreds of people fortunate enough to eat with their majesties. Their royal highnesses, the Duke and Duchess of Kent, take the opportunity to meet some of our dignitaries before accompanying their majesties to the feast and the waiting guests.
Thank you.
After the chapel coronation, the people greet their king at the traditional Tamafakava. Presentations are received from all the villages and distant island groups of the kingdom. For the people, this is the age-old acceptance of a new king, and the chance to show their love and allegiance to him. Through old associations with Fiji, the custom is for a Fijian warrior to lead His Majesty to the Pangai, where members of the nobility and the Matapuli wait in one large circle in strict order of seniority. Before counting of the gifts begins, women of high birth present beautifully fine mats, which they themselves have woven. For this tamariwha, the kava is mixed by three men instead of a girl, as is usual for less formal occasions. In a great circle, they drink from a common cup in the order which dates from antiquity. The nobles and matapuli deliver a royal admonition, begging the king to observe the patterns of majestic rules passed down by his illustrious forebears, as they in turn pledge their loyalty, support and help for unity, peace and prosperity in the kingdom. As darkness falls, the ceremony continues, solemn and unhurried, in the ancient Polynesian tradition. Expressions of goodwill continue to pour in from the rest of the world, wishing the King of Tonga a long reign, health and prosperity in the years ahead. May God bless and long live their majesties.